This is where my story begins. Forest of towering glass trees and iridescent lights. Amongst a dense and suffocating population, where the rich Oriental culture is overlapped with American influence, it seems all is tainted with Westernization in our modern days. In a city that runs a perilous succession along time's infinite passage, life surges onward both day and night, where construction never ends as the need to expand mounts along with the multiplying population. An economic monarch poised upon the Pacific's edge, it's here where my home is. Another face in the masses, another being making their way along life's steady current. The journey from British Columbia, from the stifling boundaries of Hong Kong, is like stepping out of a crowded room to breathe in the clean air outside. The endless expanse of untamed land provides the necessary clarity to complete my story. As I pursue my vision across the Pacific, I begin to realize that not every aspect of this world was presented in the form of a reverberating hub of technology. Hong Kong's strict confines offer no privacy, nowhere to hide, and nowhere to reflect. But as I follow Kiran Nikula into this expansive and foreign land, the mountains present themselves as an ideal escape. A place where my vision can prosper. Those who cultivate their lives along a visual path discover the inner somnolence which accompanies free and remote environments. Mountains that reach toward the sky and house flourishing environments. Interlaced woodlands blanket their unique and unmatched textures with luscious lividity. Where snow melts into cascading streams running vapid courses through emerald forests. And feed into frigid lakes. A place where the atmosphere is unmarred by industry, and the earth is free to shape itself as it wills. Thank you. Anatoly Borkreev once said, "Mountains are not stadiums where I satisfy my ambition to achieve. They are cathedrals where I practice my religion." The effects of a crash can be devastating. Seeing Kieran go down like that adds darker details to my perspective. The hope one feels the moment before they see their x-rays. The pungent smell of countless medicines and remedies for the incapacitated. These simple details will always come in association with injuries in my mind. When one falls into this misfortune, they lose an essential piece of themselves for a while afterwards. The letdown is detrimental, and resentment rises like a brackish tide as they lay in waiting while their body tries to regain its former mobility. Something that can be so rudimentary in almost any sport can have after effects that forever brand themselves upon one's mind. We bury those memories and push forward with righteous vitality, ready to charge into the winter months.
Oh,
Kieran and I are driven to new zones in search of winter's remains. Like two archaeologists seeking the fossilized skeleton of some prehistoric beast. Warmth. What to do with every day? What to do with working limbs? Cloudless days lose their frigid cold.
He told me, sink or swim.
We're forced onward, pursuing our love for the season with grim determination. Winter has become fragmented. Climbing north, scaling the jagged topography of British Columbia, where it can once again thrive on the higher climate. It's in these zones, where winter lasts into summer's relentless furnace, that we find its eternal cold and thrive on. As winter begins to retract itself from this part of the earth, my craving continues. Like a substance, I've succumbed to its addictive traits. It is here in British Columbia where I have found my true belonging.